But Martin will probably smell for not much longer. And next week's In the Shoes, a special phone vote to see if Di can actually get the video into the video machine. Phone in, do you think she'll be able to do it? But now, here on the A15, something that I know hundreds and thousands of people have been waiting for. We've been waiting for it too. They're here. They're live in the studio. Will you welcome Matt and Luke Goss? Let's see.
What a
dude you are. Go on. Super cool, dude. So I get to play the role here, eh? Okay, hey.
That's it, cool.
I'm cool, I'm cool now. Because you're teaching me a lot, guys, aren't you?
Yeah, because yeah, I mean, what we said about you buying it, man, it worked out, didn't it?
Exactly, that's right. These guys wanted me to go a little bit darker. I mean, you've told me everything. In fact, I owe so much to
I know.
Having met you a few years ago. Now then, it's been a couple of weird OGs, but presumably there have been a lot of funny moments as well.
Yeah, they have been pretty good. I mean, we've been working hard, but we've never felt more satisfied in what we've done.
Yeah.
You know, we feel good in ourselves, you know.
But what about the weird moments? Have you had any weird and funny moments? I have to take these shades off now.
Yeah. Weird and funny moments?
Yeah.
Doing a front cover with you the other day was a bit weird.
Yes. And we cracked two cameras, but you don't have to mention that. I mean, anything's go wrong when you're on two and things.
Yeah, we had a complete power failure once. And I'm not talking about... We still had mics on stage, but... Anything that wasn't acoustic, as in like the drums were still happening, the vocals were still happening, and we had the sax happening. And Paul, our guitarist, hi Paul, we were in the middle of some Paul's, it was in America, and we had to suddenly like improvise, and we had to do two Stevie Wonder tracks.
The most embarrassing moment was for Luke, I think you should
tell us. I've got to say
this. Go on, Luke, you can tell us.
I was coming on stage for the first time as Bros professionally ever, like the first ever gig, and then people probably remember this. And we knocked the wall down and the bricks came down and they were meant to be cleared. So I walked out, and as I walked out, I stepped and fell over on stage.
I've got to say, you can't.
Oh, no.
Yeah, you can't feel more uncool than that.
It's like you can hear 10,000 people cracking up.
You poor man.
Downer.
Anyway, new single, Are You Mine?
Yeah.
Itchy Stonker. Quite brave as well to come back with a slow number, too.
Yeah, we didn't feel it was necessary. We felt, you know, we have had 10 top 10 records and we felt that must represent something. And we felt that it now gives us the right to, if we want to come out with a real song and just come out with a bit more mellow and just say, right, here's a song, guys. You know, and that's what we did, and we're happy with it. You know, we've, year and a half away, we've come straight at number 12 now.
And of course, the album to come out in August, is it?
August, I think it's the first.
It might be a bit later that.
Now, I've heard it, well, in fact, I've heard the whole of the album now, which I have to say it's absolutely amazing. I mean, I think. But a lot of people are going to get a few surprises
there,
a few shocks there as well. There's one particular track, Try, which is my favourite.
Probably be the next single.
But there's a few other people on. You've got Mark King.
Mark King from Love 42 is playing the next single, which is brilliant. And thanks, Mark. That's brilliant playing.
Fantastic.
Watching him play is amazing.
So what would you say has been the highlight of the career so far? Would you say Wembley in front of...
Wembley was the probably... Yeah. That takes a lot of beating for us. That's, you know, 60,000, you were there.
Yeah, oh, it was an amazing
fantastic day. It's very hard to beat that.
Yeah.
That eclipses virtually everything for us.
And of course, one thing that has remained true throughout your whole career, the fans.
Yeah. Big time. I mean, it's funny. I mean, a massive thanks goes out to them because in the fact that, you know, it's a year and a half and wherever we go still, it's complete madness.
Yeah, well, we've seen that this morning.
Also, they've had...
truly loyal.
They've had... I think the word
they're all equity members, patience. Those ones, I'm sorry.
I
bought them in for you guys. No, sorry, you were saying about the fans.
They're just very, they've been very patient, I think. And
yeah.
You know, there's been a lot out there, and some of them said, oh, sorry, we weren't here, or whatever. But
yeah.
There's no contract saying they don't have to like us exclusively. And
right.
As long as the album, you know, comes out in a couple of weeks, I hope, as long as it's what they want, we'll be very happy, and I hope they're happy.
Well, we have a little something for you here, because mentioning the fans, and here a couple of them are coming in here, and we got a cake for you.
Oh, brilliant.
Come on, guys.
I'll take the cake. You cuddle the girls.
Thank you.
Thank you very much indeed. That's from lovely. Lisa, Michelle, and is it Martin
Cheers.
As well? Is
that
right?
Thank you very much.
Oh, that's it. Oh, it's your surname. I see. You're twins as well. Oh, I've just spotted that as well. There we are. There you are. Have a seat. Have a seat. Have a sit down there. There we go.
That's
sit
lovely.
Down. Do you want to squeeze on the end there? There we go. Just so we can see the cake. There we are. Any time today would be nice. That's the way we are. Lisa and Michelle Martin, thank you very much indeed for that. There we are. You look at that cake there, isn't that very, very nice indeed?
That's brilliant.
Because we love you.
You make that?
And of course, you love your fans too. So we'll get into that cake a little bit later on. Guys, I suppose that... Steady, you're not taking it away with you. We're going to eat that before the end of the show. One thing, all the problems, it must be very, very hard to have problems, but then have them in front of, you know, 60 million people or something.
I think, obviously there's so many prices to fame, it's like you can't define any of them, but I think the difference is when you have difficulties, everyone right now, the recession, everyone goes through difficulties, yeah. But I think doing it in front of 50 million people every morning is a little bit is a little bit hard to deal with. So, I mean, we did get through it. We've done, it's, at the end of this year, will be 5 years, believe it or not. And we've done our, I think then we would have done our that apprenticeship long. And nothing.
Because I remember in a radio station doing one of the first ever interviews with you before, yeah. Leaving that in 5 years.
Yeah, in 1987 in the Palais it was.
But good fun though.
Brilliant laugh.
And a tour coming up as well?
With the end of this year, we're going to do some Christmas dates in London, hopefully, which will like introduce the live situation again. It won't be the start of the tour. And then we'll probably start a tour first couple of months of next year. A world tour again.
Right.
Extensively.
Look forward to that, and of course a new album coming out. You can put the shades back on. But Di, I know you want to come back in here, don't you?